Halleluja! Stop lying! Halleluja! Stop lying! Halleluja! Stop lying! Halleluja! Stop lying!
He's lying because he's coming here to the West and talking about concepts such as love and compassion, religious tolerance and freedom. Yet, behind closed doors, he's not allowing this within the Buddhist community internationally. So he's a hypocrite.
How isn't he allowing that? Because I don't know anything about what.
Okay, he's not allowing it. Because since January this year, he enforced, and I use the term loosely, a referendum through which people were to decide if to keep or abandon a 400-year-old ancient Buddhist prayer, the very prayer that he makes his fame and fortune from teaching the commentaries to. Now, on one hand, we might think, oh, this is okay, this is democratic, but I have video footage, this is not democratic. People have to stand in front of audiences of thousands of people one by one and take an oath in front of his picture. And then reminiscent of 1930s Germany, but in reverse order, where the Jews receive a star as the victim here. If you follow the Dalai Lama's view, you get an identification card. If you don't follow his view, you have no identification card without it. You can't buy food in shops, you can't get visas for travelling, you can't get medicines in hospitals. People are having their homes burned. Thousands upon thousands of monks are homeless. Now, to be homeless as a monk, it's serious, because these people have a vow of poverty. So you're thrown out of your monastery. You've not got money saved away for a rainy day like you have in the Western countries. This is a serious crime against humanity. And yet he comes here and talks about love and compassion. He doesn't practice.
For a short time, I was out handing out literature about the issue. And for a while, people were really receptive. A lot of people were asking questions. A lot of the people attending really wanted to know about the issue. And then another group of people started appearing, and they were just hanging out around the literature distributors and giving them a hard time and spitting at them and shouting at them, so we all had to come back in because it wasn't safe anymore. Well, we were all standing on the corner chanting, "Dalai Lama, stop lying," the standard, and a large group of Tibetans came up and started jeering at us and flipping us off, and they were throwing money at us across the way, and at one point they all started running towards us. Luckily the police were there, because they were throwing bottles into the crowd. People were getting hit with bottles. I think at one point the police even tear gassed them, because they were so wild. And luckily the police were there, that's all I can say, because I felt like our lives were in danger by the Tibetan people that had come to shout at us.
Well, I personally felt quite calm, but I saw a lot of angry people, and at some point I felt a riot was going to happen, unless the police were there, you know, because there were a lot of people on the other side, and they were really angry, and a lot of them were cursing, and, you know, throwing things, but nothing hit me, but they were just waving their arms, and, you know, they were really angry, swearing, and, you know, gestures and stuff like that.
The feeling in the pen felt actually really happy. Like, it felt more and more encouraging as we kept going on. It felt like people were really just trying their hardest to stay peaceful and yet have a loud voice to let people know what was happening.
I was I was visualizing Manjushri the whole time. So maybe that's why I was so calm.
Sorry. I feel that it just proves our point that what's happening under the Dalai Lama's ban is affecting everywhere in the world, because we were surrounded by people who were trying to hurt us because of our religious belief. So I think it really just verified what we've been telling the world, that this is happening. People are being hurt or trying to be hurt by other people because of this ban.
But I was just thinking that the people on the other side, they're not very calm. They're really angry. And I just thought that was kind of odd. They just listened to a teaching from the Dalai Lama. And supposed to be on compassion. And they're not very compassionate. And it's not just one or two people, but it seems like a group of hundreds of people angry. which I think shows us something, there's something wrong with actually his teaching.
Before you die, you want to get blood from the mother.
Because I remember, I'm from Toronto, Canada, and we have a transit strike at one time, and the mayor actually said to the people who were angry not to take it out on the transit workers. Now, if somebody like that, from a worldly perspective, would know to say something like this, I would tend to think that a spiritual leader, you know, would at least be able to do the same thing.
And it was cool because we got there just in time.
Can you still move?
Yeah.
Move up, Sudan.
Small on your lap.
Yeah, move and get on lap.
Can you still move? We have still 10 people outside.
Yeah. Three to a row if you can. Seriously.